Hainan, China, August 25, 2025. Hainan, China was struck by a level 17 super typhoon, the strongest in 40 years. Skyscrapers shook, trees snapped, power exploded, and the internet was completely cut off. From the night of August 24th to the morning of August 25th, Sanya City, Hainan, endured Typhoon Swordfish, the strongest storm in the past 40 years, with gusts reaching level 17. Thousands of trees were uprooted, rooftops were torn away, and even tall buildings trembled. Sanya suffered heavy damage, and the city enforced a policy forcing tens of thousands of people to evacuate. According to Chinese media, the Hainan Provincial Information Office held a press conference on August 25th, announcing that Typhoon Swordfish strengthened into a severe storm on the afternoon of August 24th, moved towards Sanya, and brushed the southern coast of Hainan Island overnight. Although the eye of the storm did not make a direct landfall, part of it passed through Sanya, bringing destruction equivalent to a super typhoon striking the island. Level 17 winds battered Sanya for 6 hours, covering all districts. At Bailu Park Station in Sanya, wind speeds reached 42 meters per second, breaking all records since the station was established in 1958. Torrential downpours also lashed the southern half of Hainan Island. Reports from mainland media and social platforms stated that on August 24th, Typhoon Swordfish devastated Sanya, paralyzing the entire city. For the first time, authorities enforced the five stops, one closure policy. Schools closed, government offices closed, businesses shut down, public activities halted, flights canceled, and tourist attractions closed. 30,000 people were urgently evacuated. Torrential rain swept across many parts of Sanya, with winds reaching level 17 in some areas, breaking local wind speed records. Streets were destroyed, large trees uprooted, and waves as high as 8 meters slammed into the coast. Windows of seaside hotels shattered, and the city looked like a wasteland straight out of doomsday. As the storm hit Sanya, entire buildings shook and many people rushed into underground garages for shelter. On the streets, coconut trees bent in the wind, fences collapsed, tin-roofed houses rattled, and the sky turned pitch black. Under the impact of Typhoon Swordfish, strong winds and heavy rain are expected to hit many parts of Hainan Island until the morning of August 26th. Sanya endured level 17 gusts, shattering local records, along with localized torrential rain. Although the storm has moved away from Hainan, heavy rainfall continues today across central, eastern, and southern regions, with winds reaching level 12 in some areas. A Hainan resident wrote online, "The typhoon shook my building like an 8.0 magnitude earthquake. I live on the 24th floor and the building swayed back and forth like a tree." Typhoon Swordfish caused devastation, and this time Sanya suffered severe damage. "It's terrifying. I could never imagine the wind could be this strong." The storm reminded many Hainan residents of Super Typhoon Makar in 2024. Official data showed Makar affected hundreds of thousands of people in 19 cities and counties, with Haiku and Wencheng suffering the worst. The direct economic losses reached nearly 60 billion yuan. On the morning of August 25th, Mr. Yang, a resident of Tianya District Sanya, told the media he felt his building shaking violently during the strongest winds last night. His hometown is a coastal village. The windows of his family's self-built house were damaged. The colored steel sheets in the garage were ripped off, billboards and trees toppled, and many roads were blocked by flooding. "I still cannot leave my house," he said. Mr. Yang explained that his apartment was far from the sea, on the 20th floor. "Around 8 p.m., I felt the whole building swaying back and forth like a tree, whether I was lying in bed or standing." He considered hiding in the basement, but building management told residents that the swaying was a normal physical phenomenon caused by the structure releasing force. He also said his hometown, Hongtang Village in Tianya District, was battered by strong winds nearly all night until 4 a.m. The windows of his parents' self-built house and the garage roof were damaged. Due to Typhoon Swordfish, transportation across several roads in Sanya was disrupted. A video provided by residents showed countless branches and debris scattered across the streets, with trees falling along the roadside. Some roads have been partially restored. Authorities advised residents to stay indoors unless absolutely necessary. As Swordfish moved away, the city launched cleanup operations. Although not all roads have been fully reopened, the five stops, one closure policy remains in effect. According to the National Disaster Information Management System, a total of 102,500 people were affected across Hainan Province, though detailed data is still being compiled. Not only Hainan, but also Guangdong Province was hit by Swordfish. Strong winds over the Guangdong coast forced all fishing vessels west of the Pearl River estuary, including Zhuhai, to return to port. On the morning of August 24th, Guangxi's Maritime Safety Bureau raised its emergency response to level 2. The Beihai-Weizhou Island Railway line was suspended on August 24th and 25th, while local authorities activated emergency plans and evacuated more than 20,000 passengers.